Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's your brother Yahya Ibrahim with another daily tafsir. Alhamdulillah, we're doing a surah a day. And today, alhamdulillah, we're looking at Surah Al-Fajr, which is the 89th chapter of the Quran. We're looking at Juz' Amma. Surah Al-Fajr, the dawn, is a beautiful surah in the Quran. And subhanAllah, it has three main important objectives to get across to the people, the early people of Mecca. First is it speaks about the consequence of disobeying Allah out of arrogance, and it speaks about its examples from people of the past. Number two, it speaks about purifying your soul from greed and love of the worldly possessions that will distract it from the outcomes that you seek in the Akhirah. And number three, it speaks to you about life after death, that there is more to life than the life that you are living, that there's a day of judgment and a subsequent reward and punishment by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wal-fajr. And Allah makes a vow by the rising dawn, by daybreak. And Muslims, we make our early morning prayers before the rising of the dawn, before the fajr, and we recite out loud. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Qur'an al-fajri kana mashhuda, that the Qur'an that is recited in the early hours before dawn, it is witnessed by Allah, the angels are there to witness it and carry it up to Allah. وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ, by the 10 nights. And Allah makes another vow by the important time of these 10 nights, which are the 10 days of the Hijjah, according to the majority of the Mufassirin, the people of Pegasus. And they quote the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, which is narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari. And the Prophet ﷺ said that there's no good deed, there is no action of worship, there's no righteous deed on other days that are superior to those done on these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, which is soon to enter upon us. We're in Dhul Qa'dah at the moment, nearly the 10th of Dhul Qa'dah. So I want you to consider the importance of Dhul Hijjah, which is coming, which culminates with the day of Arafah on the 9th of it and the 10th of the day of Nahr, the day of Eid. And the Prophet said, not even jihad is equal to it. وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ, the even and the odd. And the even are the odd. Even is all of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the odd, al-witr, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-witr, that Allah is the one. So Allah says everything that is created, and then there is Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, He alone in His majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Other people have said odd, meaning odd out of the 10 nights, the 10 days is the day of Arafah, that is odd amongst it, and it's on the 9th day, which is the 9th day of Dhul Hijjah. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرِ, and the night when it departs, Allah makes a vow with it that there's the promise of the next day to come, there's opportunity. As dark as your life has become, dawn will always arrive. هَلْ فِي ذَلِكَ قَسَمٌ لِذِي حِجْرٍ, indeed in these oaths is sufficient proof for mankind, for those of understanding, that they should come to attention to Allah and know that Allah is always present in their life. And therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there seeking the obedience of His servants in all aspects of their life, in the darkness, in the daylight, in the days of honor, and in other than them. Then Allah begins to speak about the people of disbelief who turned away from Him. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. Look at the people who didn't obey Allah, didn't consider Allah. An example is the people of Ad, إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ, those who were tall and lofty like the pillars, they had this massive structure. الَّتِي لَمْ يُخْلَقْ مِثْلُهَا فِي الْبِلَادِ, they built foundations and homes and things that in their time had no reputable comparison to it. And they used to live in these magnificent structures. The Prophet ﷺ described them in that way. That the Prophet Hud alayhi salam was sent to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues by saying, وَثَمُود, the people of Thamud as well, الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ, they used to cleave from the rocks in the valleys to make their dwellings, and they had their massive beautiful structures. Meaning structures that could rival that which were present in Quraysh. They were generations who came many, many years, many generations before Quraysh, but they had better technology, better dwellings, better systems than what you people of Quraysh had. وَفِرْعَوْن, even further than them, is Pharaoh, ذِلْ أَوْتَاد, who had his stakes for torturing people and for punishing people. He had this power and omnipotence over much of mankind. الَّذِينَ تَغَوْا فِي الْبِلَادِ, all of these tyrants, all of them, the ones I mentioned and other than them, those who have that same disposition, Those who transgress, طغيان is to transgress bounds that are known. طغوا في البلاد in their disobedience of Allah, فأكثروا فيها الفساد. And therein they cause much mischief and corruption upon the earth. فصب عليهم ربك صوت عذاب. Eventually, nevertheless, your Lord will always eventually pour down upon them different levels of severe torment and punishment. وَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. Allah describes in Surah Al-Ankabut, each of these peoples, we took them on accordance to their sins that they performed. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ. Those who the earth swallowed up to open them. Others, the wind came to them. Others, the strike came upon them. Others, أَغْرَقْنَا, we caused them to drown. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ. Your Lord is always watching over all of us, over the sinners, in his power to desist and stop them eventually, and in his overwatchfulness of the pious who are weak, who he will attest. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانِ. Mankind is prone that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests them, tries them by giving honorable things, things that they're happy to receive, they say, my Lord has honored me, they're happy. And إِذَا ابْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ. But when Allah makes the means of their life a little bit more difficult, health begins to fail, wealth is not as much, they say, قَالَ رَبِّ أَهَانَ. And he says, my Lord has turned away from me, has humiliated me. كَلَّا بَلَّا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ. No, rather than thinking about what Allah has done to you, what have you done for those who are weak, like the orphans? What have you done with those who others overlook? وَلَا تَحَاضُونَ عَلَى طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينَ. You don't feed the weak. وَتَأْكُلُونَ التُّرَاثَ أَكْلًا لَمَّا. You devour the inheritance of others unjustly. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. And your greed and love of wealth is excessive. كَلَّا إِذَا دُكَّتِ الْأَرْضُ دَكًّا دَكًّا. Where will you, what your condition will be when the earth is ground to a powder? وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. When your Lord comes and arrives with the angels in rows for his judgment, as is described in numerous hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمَ. In one hadith the Prophet said, يَجِيءُ بِجَهَنَّمْ سَبْعُونَ لَهَا سَبْعُونَ أَلْفَ ذِمَامٍ. A Jahannam will be brought forward and it'll be pulled forward with 70,000 chains, an incalculable number of chains that the angels will bring it forth. يَوْمَئِذٍ. Jahannam will be brought near on that day. يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانِ. Mankind will deliberate upon their previous life. وَأَنَّ لَهُ الذِّكْرَ. And how good their memory will be. And they will think about their remembrance. And how will that remembrance avail them today? What will you say? What excuse will you be able to come up? Oh, I did this because of this. يوم يقول يا ليتني. Rather, all that will come to mind is you will say, يا ليتني. I wish I had. Alas, had I done. قدمت لحياتي. I wish I had saved good deeds for this day. I wish I had lived a righteous life. فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد. On that day, none will be punished as he has been punished. وَلَا يُوثِقُ وَثَاقَهُ أَحَدٌ. And none will be bound as he will be bound. None will be tied up and restrained as much as they will be restrained. يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةُ. On the other hand, there will be souls that find rest and tranquility with Allah. O soul of the righteous believers, who has found rest and satisfaction after your difficult life. ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية. Return to your Lord being well pleased with yourself and well pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي. Enter amongst my honored servants, enter into my paradise. Subhanallah, what a beautiful end to the difficulties that are faced in the world. And Allah begins this surah by speaking about the consequence of disobeying Allah, being from the followers of Ad and Thamud and Fir'aun, being of that one who doesn't think of the next day to come, that the greed of this life makes them turn away from Allah, that they forget that the rizq is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when Allah takes something from us that we consider, ah, oh, Allah has humiliated us, debased us, why isn't Allah kind to me? Forgetting that perhaps in our poverty is our medicine and in our wealth is our destruction. Knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeks for us to be pure before we return to Him, to clarify our dealings of Him, to live a life that is pleasing to Him, so that our death will be one where we hear those words of the angel of death, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةُ إِخْرُجِي إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَضْوَانٍ. O soul who is pleasing to Allah, exit to the mercy of Allah and His contentment with you. وَرَبٍ عَنْكِ رَاضٍ عَنْكِ غَيْرَ غَضْبَانٍ. And your Lord is pleased with you and not vengeful with wrath towards you. May Allah bless us with that. This was another daily tafsir with your brother Yahya Ibrahim. from a surah a day, from Juz Amma. This was surah number 89, Surah Al-Fajr. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.